Hey guys, it's me and Hawk Dog. Come on, let's go. Let's go check out some comics in the Hawk's Nest. Come on, buddy. There he is. Come on down. You know what? We get by, me and Hawk Dog. Hey guys, welcome to the Hawk's Nest. Jake, come on, man. Oh yeah, we're hanging out. Come on now. No more class on Starman. You know, everyone got their diploma. Guys, thanks for hanging out. It means a lot. Everyone got their Starman Academy diploma, all right? Hero diploma, Opal City University. Guys, Starman was great. I had to get it out of my system. That whole series by James Robinson made an impression on me when I was younger, and it got me back into comics, and it kicked off the JSA run by Jeff Johns, which was fantastic. Guys, you're the best. Thanks for joining me. Oh, yeah. Hawk Dog, thanks, pal. I'll take it from here, man. Yeah. So I, you know what this is my Batman, Catwoman. she was getting uppity. She's got a good dental plan. Where's my other Batman? Hold on. Oh, yeah. Both of these guys, see, they're the same size. Look at that. Different times. I found both of these in the trash. Oh, other people's garbage is my gem. You never know what you're going to find. And I made this cape. Oh, yeah, I'm a tailor. Perfect. Look at these guys. They're pals. Oh, yeah, they go way back. Good times. You guys hang out here. See, I got friends. I got Kissinger over there. He's sniffing glue like it's the end of times. I mean, I don't need my wife. My wife could go out of town. I got friends. She says I get weird when she goes out of town. I said, nah. So anyways, look what I found when I was at work yesterday. Where did I put that thing? Where did I put it? Over here, look. So, we're working. More garbage. This is a tin, right? It was run over a couple times, but it has a puzzle in it. Yes, a puzzle with, it's like a little, it's for little kids. But you make the puzzle, and it has Black Adam on it. Oh yeah, see? More garbage. Bring it on down to the Hawk's Nest. But, guys, seeing how I had a busy week with the Starman stuff, I got an overflow of comics because I'm out there, baby. And look at this. I got a package in the mail. Oh, yeah. We got a lot to go over. I went to Harvey's. I'm so wild about Harvey. I went to DJ's Cards and Comics in North Haven. And, of course, I went to Second Alarm Comics. Everyone's like, okay. All right, so let's get to it. All right. Now, let's open the... Sonia! There you are, looking good. Happy Sunday. All right, let's keep this Sunday civil. Sword, please. My letter opener. Thank you, sweetie. Oh, man, you smell good. You took your monthly shower. Oh, what's the name of that perfume? The blood of your enemy? I love it. Get a bottle for Hawk Woman. Thank you. All right, so I give a little present I gave to myself. All right, let's see what we got here. What do we got here? Let's find a good angle. Here's an angle. All right, here we go. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, death blow. Yeah. Crush your enemy. All right, thank you. All right, Sonya, thank you. All right, today we're going to plant some flowers in the yard, all right? All right, give it. All right. Thank you. Sharpen that and oil it. Tell your mother I said hi. Thank you. All right, let's see what we got here. Alright. We got more. Yeah, so I've been getting comics all week, you know. And I had to do a little stuff. I had to bone up on my Starman to present it. You guys did great. All the grades beside Easy got like a C minus. I had to help him out. Easy. Some things aren't easy, are they, Easy? Alright, man. Easy Comics Reader. You gotta check out his channel. Okay, let's see what I got. Forever people! Forever and ever we go. Forever People, issue number 11. This is the last issue in the Jack Kirby run. And I have the only issue I do not have is issue number 1. But I have the omnibus over there. And I love the Forever People. I mean, look at Big Bear. I mean, that's a look it's hard to pull off. There's Beautiful Dreamer, where everyone's there. Where's the kid with the pistolas? There he is. Seraphim. There's a Viking Black. There's a Archie Farchinero. I forgot his name, but I needed it. I couldn't find this sucker anywhere. Even Jim from Second Alarm. I gotta show you Second Alarm Comics. Oh, I gave him that that painting I did. Oh yeah, and I was in there, right? And he said, I just got out of work. I go into Jim's Second Alarm Comics. I'm like this. I'm like, he's like, he's like, Jim, because I never seen him since I gave him the painting. But he says, thank you for the painting. I said, my pleasure, pal. I said, I'm honored you even hung it up. I'm surprised you didn't throw it right in the dumpster. He's like, no, man, thank you. He goes, I want to put something on Instagram. I'm glad you're here. He goes, I wish you had your wife beater on, though. I said, the wife beater's always on. You never know when there's a wife that needs to be beaten. I said, it's underneath. So I took my work jacket off, and I said, this is the commercial. Here, this is what it is. Check it out.
Hi, guys. We're here live from the shop, Second Alarm Comics. We're 205 Foxer Road in North Branford, Connecticut. And wanted to highlight a couple things in store today. We'd love for you to stop down and see what we have. But real special is we have
a great picture
guest star here. It's Higgy Pop.
You selling this stuff?
Higgy Pop is
I'm
here.
Just here for my jacket, Jim. Thank you. Thank you for being nice enough to hang this. I mean, I spent hours.
So guys, we are super fortunate.
You got
to
come down. Nothing like Jim's shop. Second Alarm charm all the way. I mean, look at these books. He's practically giving it away.
Jim's down here all the time picking up some great stuff.
It's 2 minutes from my house. It's a guy. I got to get 3 jobs. You're the best. But, great shop.
But we have this wonderful sign that Jim did for us. What a nice gesture, and we love it. So we
Hawk want
to stop down. The original Hawkman, Jim Higgins, live in store in the white beater, no less.
Yes. There's no more Hawkman comics in the shop.
And guys, don't forget, check out Jim Higgins at Higgy Pop Comics on YouTube. See you soon in the store.
Good times. Good times. Good times at Second Alarm. Whenever you guys are in town, let's go. So let's see. I went to Harvey's. Harvey, he's like, hey, Jim, how you doing? I said, I'm doing good, man. I mean, there was nothing great in there. I went over this stuff a couple times already, but I found some stuff that grabbed my eye. I saw this. Chuck Dixon. Chuck Dixon is one of my favorite writers. I mean, the way he wrote Bane and the way he broke Batman's back. Batman. Oh, that was funny. And but I saw this. This is by Chuck Dixon and Larry Stroman on the art. This is Alien Legion, On the Edge. This is book one, all right? These are like thick. These are fatties, all right? I got all three. They're at Harvey's, Coins and Collectibles. And he's like, hey, Jim, I'll see what you, whatever you want, pal. I said, all right. And these are out in space. These are like space pirates. These are the worst of the worst people, but they turn into heroes, apparently. I did not get to read it. That's book two. I mean, check it out. Supposedly, there's like great aliens they have in here, and it's good stuff. And we have book three, Alien on the Edge. I mean, hello. So, Lead Paint sent me a chat, right? He's like, hey. He's like, why don't you stop licking your fingers when you turn the pages? Hey, Lead, how am I supposed to turn the page? Telekinesis? I'm gonna go to the meat market. I'm going to buy a big cow tongue and lay it right here. Just go like this. Flip. Flip. Would that help? Lead, I don't know what else to do. My hands are dry. And then I found this. The same thing. Chuck Dixon and Larry Stroman. Alien Legion, Tenants of Hell. Book one. This is another fatty. All right. This is cool, man. I'm going to do some reading because it makes me smart. Tenants of Hell, book two. This is just a two-issue run. So I'm going to check it out. I am. Let's check out the art inside. This is the art inside. I love it. I love it already. 2 thumbs up. I love it. Come on now. Let me lick my finger. Turn the page. I mean, look at the action. Look at the action. Lead, I will figure something out. No more licking of the fingers. God, I grossed myself out. And then, okay, if as you guys recall, I bought that book about, it was called The Draft, and then it was something else, and it all started with The Pit. So I found this. I thought I had it. It's probably in here in the Hawk's Nest somewhere, but Byrne was involved, Grunewald, and Buscema. they introduce the pit. That's when a big hole blows up in Pittsburgh. And then the books I bought a couple weeks ago from Harvey's had it when these people start getting superpowers, all right? And then they get drafted, and they want to find all the people with superpowers and make a team. This is where it all started, the pit. This came out in, like, 90-something. But you've seen it. You've seen it around. So I had to get that to go with my other books. These things got to make sense. But this was great. Once I saw this, this is by Vertigo, all right? DC Vertigo. Unknown Soldier, 1 through 4. Oh, my Lord. I know there's some Unknown Soldier fans out there. The old Joe Kubert Unknown Soldier. Kubert, Mr. Kubert, looking good. Oh, yeah, look at him. Yeah, with the headband. Oh, Mr. Kubert, you're a legend. You're a legend. You're the best. Hawkman soda. It gives you wings. Things are happening around here, man. Unknown Soldier. Harvey had 1 through 4. Check it out. All right. This is brought to us by Garth Ennis. You know him. And Killian Plunkett. All right. I mean, look at the art inside. Beautiful. Beautiful. Unknown Soldier is a great story. And I'm just going to see where this takes me. I got all 4 issues. That's issue number 1. DC Vertigo. All right. It's like he's got all the bandages. Like he cut himself shaving. Very bad. Very bad. It's like he was shaving during an earthquake. Hey, guys, did you catch the earth? Over here in Connecticut, on the East Coast, from Jersey up, they said there was an earthquake the other day. These earthquakes, they got to stop. Everyone, now, a friend called me, like, hey, did you feel the earthquake? I was like, nah. Oh, yeah, I felt it, baby. Oh, yeah. No, the earthquake. I mean, it's like, this is issue number 3 of 4. This earthquake, it turned into like Woodstock. Remember, like everyone talks about Woodstock. Nowadays, everyone's been to Woodstock. Oh, yeah. I was at Woodstock. Where'd this come from? You weren't even born. I was there. Now everyone feels the earthquake. Oh, yeah, man. Things are falling off the shelf. I saved a baby from a crack in the street. Holy mackerel. This is issue number 4. And things are not looking good. Unknown Soldier. And then, that's all I got from Harvey's. In and out, I said, hi, Harvey. He's like, hey, Jim, how you doing? And then I have a friend from Facebook Marketplace, my friend Zach. I got comics from Zach once before because he lives down the street from me in East Haven. So when I see him on Facebook Marketplace, I'm like, this guy's a neighbor. So he has some comics every once in a while. I get them. And I saw these gems. I'm like, hey, Zach, it's Hig. He's like, yeah. So we met at Dunkin' Donuts, and I grabbed these. Walt Disney's Huey, Dewey, and Louie. This was a blast. This is number 56. All right. This is a Whitman variant. These were all Gold Key originally, I believe. And Huey, Dewey, and Louie. Look at him. Look at the frog in their sleeping bags. He's like, I'm out of here, baby. Mm-hmm. I love it. Number 56. This is back in June of 79. I will rip out your spine. And then I got Winnie the Pooh. I like Eeyore. I lost my tail again, Pooh. This is August of 79. This is number 14. All right. And these are just Bronze Age beauties that he had. And these are in great shape. Thank you, Zach. Zach's a cool dude. He's an artist. Like we all try to be artists. I try my best. And I see Zach around town. And he goes to flea markets and stuff. He got these at some flea markets. And easy, by the way. I used some more of your cards that you sent me for the Conan. I put them on the Conan metal cabinet. Oh, yeah. Everything's shaping up around here, pal. Thank you. And I got Sylvester and Tweety, a Whitman variant. Look at him with the tennis ball thing. He's like, boom, 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 boom. Oh, yeah. This is issue number 51. This is November of 75. Staying alive, staying alive. Oh, yo, let's play tennis, Stephanie. Yes. He's doing his John McEnroe. John McEnroe was always angry. That ball was in! I will kill your family! We need tennis players like John McEnroe. He was angry. And this is the last one I got from my boy Zach. Walt Disney, Uncle Scrooge. Yes, a 30 center. It's bad luck in the big bunches when Scrooge buys the doomed diamond. All right? I read this one last night. And I laughed. He goes against, you know, the Beagle boys are in there. And they're so mean to the Beagle Boys. I mean, they're all after the diamond and the doomed diamond. Of course, Scrooge McDuck, he has his own submarine. That's not fair. And this is October of 76. We were all picking up sticks. This is issue number 133. Love it. So I got my Forever People. We'll go over Forever People someday. I love it. They're like, they're very happy kids. I mean, they're new gods. What's to be mad about? And it's funny. I was talking to Rigor Mortis the other day. Rigor Mortis 86. And he says, he's like, you know, I was going to get, we're talking about a comic. He goes, I was going to get that comic. He was talking about Starman. I was going to get those, but I had to buy clothes instead. Listen to me. I get it. I mean, Hawkwoman's always yelling at me because she says, you look like you're wearing rags. I said, whoa, I like these clothes. So I go to DJ's Cards and Comics, and it's just not the same. I go in there like this, and everyone's just like, I'm like, hello? And they're like, I'm like, Higgy. You're like, nothing. It's not the same atmosphere as Second Alarm. So, Rigor Mortis, I get it, man. I was, one time I was in the grocery store with my wife. This was like about 5 years ago. And I'm wearing what I wear. And this little kid was near his mommy. They're in the shopping cart in the checkout line. And the kid goes, mommy. Is that a homeless man? My wife goes, see? I'm like, no, little guy. I do have a home. It's just my wife doesn't buy me new clothes. I got this. Hulk, issue number 159. Herb Trempe cover. Oh, yeah, baby. The Abomination. That's what I dress like, the Abomination. One time we were out at a store. It's like a department store. And there was this little kid, and they had all the clothes, right? The clothes racks with the mannequins. And this little kid, he sits there, and he's waiting for me and my wife to walk by, and he's like, he's pretending to be a mannequin. He's like this. So we play it off, and like, me and my wife go, oh, wow, look at these. That's a nice shirt, man. That's, wow, what a great looking mannequin. And the kid's playing it off. He's like, and then we walk by, and then he goes, hey, Mom, they thought I was really a mannequin. What? That kid, he's going places. So this is issue number 159. This is January of 75. And so I went a little Hulk crazy. I got some Hulks and inks by Sal Trapiani. Oh! And the Hulk busters come after the Hulk, and then the Abomination, they wake up the Abomination. He was like in a coma for 2 years, and he's like, what's all the noise? And then he fights the Hulk. This is great stuff. Classic Marvel. Then I picked up issue 155, The Incredible Hulk. A world he never made. You have journeyed far to die, monster, and at the hand of Captain Axis. Blitzkrieg, 1972, Cuckoo Ka-Choo. And Herb Trempe and John Severin. Not Marie Severin. And this is September of 72. Destination Nightmare. Herb Trempe does all the art inside. And Bruce Banner, he starts shrinking. He goes into the microverse and all sorts of stuff. And in here, it's funny because General Ross, they show his office and his library. And in one of his books in his library is King Cole by Ron E. Howard. Oh, yeah. It's great. I was like, that's King Cole. Here's a Mark's Jewelers. Oh, yeah. Only the best. Simply the best. I'm licking my fingers because that's what I do. I got to turn the pages. I got to. Yeah, so all great stuff. Hulk no like. Hulk's taking a blast right in the chest. Ooh. Great stuff. Now he's throwing things. That's what he likes to do. And there's Bruce Banner. Floating through the microverse. Let me show you King Cole in his library. I mean, these are the things that get me going, baby. It's the little things. There's Blitzkrieg. Look at the shape of his head. It's like, whoa. Bullet head. He's a hard guy to... You can't hang a guy like that. He's got no neck and he's got a bullet head. Where's Sam Lane's library? I can't find it. Oh, well, believe me, it's in there. Issue number 155. Look through there, and you'll see Sam Lane has King Cole in his library. Do you believe me? Come on, guys. You trust me, right? Oh, yeah. One of the guys that watches my channel, Lizaban Adventures. His mom passed away Monday. And prayers, man, I've been praying for you and your family. And bless your mother, you know. Thank you for all you do for me, man. And I'm praying for you and your family, buddy. Issue number 103, The Incredible Hulk. Ah, look at that. I love this guy's sword. This is Marie Severin and Frank Giacoa. Oh, on the cover. This is May of 68. We were all closing the gate. It says, and now the space parasite. He's the space parasite. He wants the Hulk's power. He sees how powerful the Hulk is. He's like, I need it. I need some of that gamma radiation, baby. And Gary Frederick is the writer. Art is Marie Severin. And inks are by Frank Giacoa. And hey, you'll bring my Brigitte. And the space parasite, man. He's an Exorian. He's from the planet X or something. And it's great. The Hulk just got back from Asgard, getting his butt kicked in Asgard, and he comes right back to this crap. I mean, he can't get a chance. Puny humans! So, I Hulked out, man. So then, I picked this up at DJ's Cards and Comics. I don't think I have this one. I'm looking at the wall, because if I had it, it would be on the wall. But I don't. This is World's Finest, issue number 156. And that's Bizarro Batman. Bizarro, number one, Superman, created a Bizarro Batman. So then they freed a Joker because Joker is good, man. See? And this is March of 66. Oh, those were the days. This is in a condition of whoa minus. But I had to get it because I didn't have it. And there's great stories in here. There's a Tommy Tomorrow story in here. It's great. Yes. Puzzle of the Perilous Planetoid. Anything with Tommy Tomorrow, Space Ranger, anything like that, I got to jump on, man, because I love it. So, this is a winner, chicken dinner. And this is the first World's Finest to feature the Go-Go Checks. Rod! The Mad Marauder, Rod! Great show Saturday. Oh, yeah, baby. I catch it on the rerun. I dropped in and out because I was at work. Hey, I'm out there working hard, you know, watching Comic Book Memories. But, it was cold out Saturday down here, man. I'm telling you what. It's colder than Beckerman's third nipple down here. I'm telling you, baby. Oh, yeah. And, but that's a classic. That's a classic. Bizarro Batman and Bizarro Superman. And, just shenanigans. So I went with the... Woo! Oh, yeah. We gotta do it. Let's do it. Oh, yeah. Why you... You walk! Jonah Hex. Hey, Jonah, what's wrong with your face? Your mama don't even like you, Jonah. That's Wolf Boy. And that's J.M. Marbury. He turned into Wolf Boy. And All-Star Western was, this started off at All-Star Western, 1 through 11. And then from 12 to issue 71, it was Weird Western Tales. That's where I got my Scalp Hunter run. I went over Scalp Hunter. That was one of the early Higgy videos when everything was silly. And this great, great bar fight in here. Jonah is like, whomping and a stomping. They said, hey, boy, what's wrong with your face? And Jonah's like, here, let me show you. He just kicks Cooley. Jonah's like, whack! He just stomps on him. He gets nuts. Look at him go. Look at him go! He don't need no six shooter. He's just clomp. Man, great book. And it is done by Luis Dominguez on the cover. Luis Dominguez and Tony Dizaniga does all the art inside. Tony. Classic. This is issue number 18. And I need it. I needed it. Now I got it. Woo! Then, I was just on Psychotronic Squirt Gun's live show on Wednesday. I was on in the last 2 minutes. And I was just explaining it to him because we're talking about Atlas Comics. And I was like, all I need for Atlas is I need more Western books. And I found one. Boom! You know, guys, you put it out there in the universe and it happens, baby. This is a gun. This is Kid Cody Gunfighter and the Comanche Kid. They're introducing the Comanche Kid, which is great. And this is such a good book. And the Comanche Kid he's White Eagle, all right? And it's the first appearance of the Comanche Kid in this. And this is done by, Doug Wildley does all the art inside. And he does a great job. And Doug Wildley was known for the Johnny Quest cartoon. Fantastic. Yes. And, you know, he worked for Hanna-Barbera. He did the Outlaw Kid. Doug Wildley. And the Comanche Kid, White Eagle, is a great story, man. It really is. Let me show you. What is this here? Alright. This is the Comanche Kid. Alright. The Comanche Kid, he saves this guy from a mountain lion. That's him right there. Great stuff. Look at that. Isn't that great? Atlas Comics. This is issue number one. Introducing the Comanche Kid in the second story. So, that makes, I think, like three Westerns that I have for Atlas Comics. And they're hard to find, man. They're hard to find out there. And then, I made a mistake. I already have this. This is DC Firehair. This is DC Showcase. This is September of 69. This is DC Showcase 85. I wanted to complete my Firehair run. I didn't have my list for Firehair. So I come home, and I already have it. All right. I did draw Hawkman on the back. He's like, why? Why? I left my wings in the car. Why? And it's cool, though. In this, they show you how to do Indian sign language in this. They're like,
white man, get out. White man, go on home.
That's fire hair. Good stuff. And then I picked this up. Knight Rider! He is the Knight Rider. This is like the cover's by Dick Ayers. And it's like, it's a reprint of Ghost Rider. This appears in Ghost Rider number 5. I read this story before. It's the tarantula. It's a meetup with the tarantula again. And Gary Friedrich is the writer. And yeah. And it's good stuff. Inks are by Vince Coletta. Knight Rider. There's a rip on the front cover. And I said, oh yeah, you're coming home with me, baby. You're coming home with me. I mean, this guy, I went out of there, man. I spent like $1. That's what I like to do. Very frugal. Very frugal. Very frugal indeed. So then, now, Second Alarm Comics. I'm like, Jim, all right, guys, relax. I'm just here to shop. I put my legs on, my pants on, one leg at a time. Sometimes, I jump right into them. That's when I know I'm going to have a good day. All right, I went back. This came out a couple weeks ago, but I heard good things about it. Batman, Dark Age. All right. This is the same guy that does, like, this is Mike Allred and his wife, what's her face, Linda Allred or something. Same kind of art. And so I read this. This is very good. I'm going to keep up with it. Book one. All right. And these are all from my poll list this week. I showed you these, but I'll tell you what. Shazam is strong. It's really good. It turns out his new house that was given to him by Zeus, I thought it was Black Adam, but Zeus gave it to him because they destroyed it. It's a portal, dimensional portal. Every time you go inside, you don't know what you're going to come across. So that's fun. And these are the other two. You know, Neil before Zod. Ursa is crazy. But the thing is, they killed Ursa, but it turns out Ursa was pregnant. We didn't know that. Whoa. So Zod is mad. Nothing like a mad Zod. I mean, and Superman 78. It was good. I mean, it shows you what Superman can do. He did not punch his way out of this. He was in Russia, and he talked to Metallo. He's like, hey, Metallo, let's go have a cup of coffee and talk about this. That's what peace is all about. Peace, brother. All right. Love, peace, and hair grease. Now, I did some stuff, baby. So, I was at gym. We were talking. I was hanging out, and I got this beauty. 80-page giant. This is a fatty. World's Finest, issue number 179. I did not have this. This is chock full of stories, baby. This is November of 68. And the cover's by Neil Adams. Oh, yeah. And Ann Kerswan. And Win Mortimer. And the first story is The Origin of Superman, Batman Team. Great. And then there's The Mightiest Team in the World. All right. That's by Kurt Swan. Then the third story is Batman, Double Force Superman, Kurt Swan. Then there's When Gotham City Challenged Metropolis. Good stuff. And then The Dictator of Kandor. That's written by Bill Finger. His middle name is an old Yiddish name they very rarely use anymore. Bill Pulmy Finger. And Dick Sprang did the art on that. And then the last story was Club of Heroes by Dick Sprang. It's a fatty. Oh, yeah. Nice. And then I got World's Finest. And my wife's, I'm in the store, my wife's calling me. She's like, I'm just worried about you. I don't like you home alone, you know. And I didn't have this one. Issue number 253. Yeah. So I'm like, listen, I'm in the comic store. Don't bother me. I know, you tend to get a little weird when you're alone. I said, I'm not weird. Not me. Jim Aparo on the cover. And there's five great stories in this. And Don Newton. Remember Don Newton? I had him over there. Don Fig Newton. And, oh, yeah. But I told her. I said, listen, I'm fine. Don't worry about me. I said, I got friends. Look at the cover. See that? Look at the creeper. They're all there. Superman's got Batman in the chokehold. He's got him in a chokehold, baby. So I told Hawk Woman. I said, my friends are here. I said, this is how I pass the time. Look at this. See this? This is what I do. My friends come over, like Easy came over. Look at this. Easy. I said, hey, Easy. He's like, hey, how you doing? Hey, how you? Hey, Superman, put Batman down. I was like, easy. Get out of there, will you? All right, Jim. Hey, Jim, nice. Thanks for letting me stop by. I said, no problem, pal. All right, Easy. See you later. And then all of a sudden, Beckerman's like, hey, Batman, where's the glue? Hold him down, Superman. I know he's got glue on him in the utility belt. And I was like, Beckerman, get out of there. You know? So I got friends, man. I told her. I said, you just got to relax. I said, me and Hawk Dog, I said, there's nothing weird going on around here. Nothing weird. And, I mean, I am sane as a bird. And then, Psychotronic Squirt Gun came over. He's like, hey, Jim, I'm having a show on Wednesday night. I know you can't make it, so I'm going to keep it on Wednesdays. I said, all right, Gunner, no problem. All right, Jim, thanks for stopping by. Bye. And then my buddy Ron, who's doing great, he's recovering from back surgery, and he's home. He's home reading comics. But his back hurts, so that's why he's a little crooked. See him? He's got a kink. He's like, oh, Jim, where's the couch? I said, it's over there, Ron. All right, I'll see you later. Bye. And see? Everything's fine here. I'm not weird. Everything's fine. But this is loaded with great stories. It's got all sorts of stories in there. It's got stories by Green Arrow, The Creeper, Shazam. The art in Shazam is fantastic. There's The Creeper. See, Green Arrow. Green Arrow has a two-part story in here with Black Canary. It's just fantastic stuff. Look at that. Captain Marvel. Right? Good stuff. That's issue number 253. And then, here I come to save the day. It's Mighty Mouse. He's on his way. On the sea or on the land. Issue number 53. Al Kilgore. Art. Just January of 62. I had to get it. Look at that. I used to love watching the Mighty Mouse cartoon. Those were the days. A simpler time. And then, I completed my... I'm not going to be able to get issue number one on this because... Unless I get a condition of... Whoa! The Man Called Nova. Issue number 24. Carmine Infantino and Gaspar Saladino! On the cover. There's the Pharaoh. I mean, they got the diamond heads in there somewhere. Yeah, they're fighting it all. It's a lowdown, drag down. The new champions, all right? This is what it's called. And March of 79. And he teams up, Nova Tank teams up with a 1950s fighter, hero, the Crime Buster. Power, what's his name? Comet. Comet is his name, the guy in the red. And he's with Crime Buster or whatever, and Powerhouse. This cover was like an homage to X-Men 100. Issue number 24. Come on, Infantino! And I got issue number 20, The Man Called Nova. Nova, you've killed my father! That's his brother. His brother has a robot that's like Sherlock Holmes. The robot's like this. Don't trust him, Robbie. Robbie, come on now. He's up to no good. I mean, look at this. I mean, it's ridiculous. Yes. So, at last, The Inner Circle, this one's called. Marv Wolfman's the writer. Carmine Infantino. And Gaspar Saladino does the letters. And his brother, Robbie, has this robot that thinks it's Sherlock Holmes. He thinks he made the robot, but the robot is by an evil alien, and they're monitoring Nova. I don't want to spoil it, but it was like 40 years ago. And July of 78, baby. So all I need is issue number one for Nova. So I guess I'll never complete it. And Shannon, I picked this up because this is the new Planet of the Apes coming out. All right. This was free by Marvel. It looks dang good, buddy. It looks dang good. I mean, when you see an ape wearing shoulder pads, a hammer, and a sickle, look out. They like to eat faces, so just
looks good, right?
Yes. Good stuff. So I've been keeping myself busy. I had friends come over, as you see. All is well. I think Hawk Dog just took a taxi to get out of here. All right. It's me and Sonya, I guess.
All right.
And I got this on the cheap. Son of Satan, issue number one. Guillotine! Insane in the membrane! Insane in the brain! This is December of 75. And Mike Esposito helps him out on the cover. And the writer is John Warner. And I'm getting into the Son of Satan. I got like 6 issues so far. And Jim Mooney does the art inside. The art inside was a little mez-a-mez. Jim! Pull it together, buddy. But that's issue number one. He's a cool character. I dig him. Son of Satan, your horses are on fire. And, oh, this is great. Tower of Shadows, King Size Special, number one. This has everyone on it. This cover's by John Romita. You like Romita Coladas? And getting caught in the rain. You like drawing comics after midnight. Stay away from rigor mortis, his glue. And December of 71, there's like five stories in here. And 2 of the stories are done by Jim Steranko. Wow. And there's 1 story done by Neil Adams. And then there's one, the last story is done by Jack Kirby and Steve Ditko. The cover was detached when I got this home. And I was like, oh. But I'm going to show you anyways. I'm going to show you Steve Ditko and Jack Kirby. It's in a condition of, whoa. I mean, the cover is detached. Lick. And the last story. This is it, baby. I opened the door to nowhere. All right. Jack Kirby and Steve Ditko. Opened the door to nowhere, and then I closed it. But, yeah, the cover's got some problems. It's got some problems. But it's all good, baby. I love it. It's in a good home. It's our job to take care of these things. Yes. Neil Adams, I think, is in the second story. Let's see here. It's Neil Adams style. Beautiful stuff. I love it. Had to get it. And then I picked up Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, Supernatural Thrillers, issue number 4. This was pretty fun. Ron Wilson on the cover. This is June of 75. And Ernie Chan and John Romita helped him on the cover. This is the Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde story. And it's different than what I thought it would be. I mean, Mr. Hyde, Dr. Jekyll is like, he just goes around town as Mr. Hyde. Let's see. Mr. Hyde is crazy. He's going around town. He's doing crazy stuff. He's doing drugs. He's beating kids in the street. He's kicking people in the teeth. And then the town is like, what are you doing? And then he finally dies, and he turns back into Dr. Jekyll. And they're like, oh, my God. We thought he was a nice man. See, you got to be a nice guy. I try to be a nice guy. I do. When I was younger, when I was a teenager, I got into a little, you know, I was doing silly stuff. Like one time, we're driving through town as kids, listening to Ride the Lightning. And we saw the KFC that had the big sign, right? And it said, cool guys, it says, cool guys pick chicken and biscuits on the sign. It had the letters that you could arrange. So I went up there, I snuck up there, and I put, cool guys beat kids. And I was like, ah! It was up there for like 2 days. People were like, what the hell? And that's just, you know, kid stuff. One day, okay, this I picked this up. Adventure Comics, issue number 461. This was fun. Fun stuff. This is February of 79. Jim Aparo on the cover. Isn't that great? And there's a Flash story by Irv Novik. And then there's the Dead Man story by Jim Aparo. Then there's the JSA, Only Legends Live Forever. That's by Joe Staton. Right there. And then there's an Aquaman story, Ron, by Don Newton, not the Fig. And then there's a Wonder Woman story with Wonder Girl. And it's in great shape, man. I love it. And let me show you the back cover. It's fun. Look at this. Isn't that great? There's Hawkman. He's watching everyone six. He's like, I'm 4 clicks out. You guys are looking good. It's a go. We got a green light. Our man. Oh, yeah, baby. Dr. Midnight. Wildcat. Good stuff. So I got that. I was very happy. I left there a happy man. Second Alarm Charm. And one time we did do a little thievery. We were always going fishing, right? And there was a state garage where they do have all the plows and their equipment. Here's Adventure Comics, issue number 371. Sorry to quit the Legion, old buddies, but that's the way the kryptonite crumbles. I've got to join a new team. When Superboy walked out on the Legion, they're like, Murr. He's like, see you later, bye-bye, gotta go. I got an overhead suitcase here, I gotta go. I mean, he could fly home, but no. This is August of 68, the cover's by Neil Adams. It's in a condition of, whoa, plus. He's like, And Jim Shooter and Kurt Swan do all the art inside. Old Jim Shooter, Jim Shooter writes it, young Jim Shooter. And there's another story, Colossal Failure, with Colossal Boy. Jim Shooter does everything on that one. And, yeah, it's good stuff. No, 68. Yeah, that's a year before Woodstock. I was in Woodstock. Yeah, sure you were, pal. You were like 2. You were still putting mustard stains in your diaper. So we were kids. Well, I don't know. We were like 16 years old, so we're going fishing all the time. We're always walking by this chain link fence, and the state garage had all their equipment there. We fished this river for trout fishing. Oh yeah, it's like a river run through it. And then there was always this like dirt bike on the ground. It was like an old dirt bike. It was a trials bike. It's like from the 70s. It was a Montesa trials bike. This is cool. And the cover's done by Carmine Infantino and Neil Adams. They're like, shoo, all right. And so this bike was there for like, we walked by it for like 2 weeks straight, and it was just like falling apart. And they're like, we should take that. I said, yeah, no one's going to miss that. So we pull up the bottom of the fence, and I drag it out underneath the fence. And then we got that thing fired up. That's how I learned how to ride a motorcycle. I shouldn't. I am not the ghost rider, I'll tell you that. The first day on the bike, my buddy's a huge dirt bike rider. Right? We find this open grass lot. He's like, all right, Jim, now this is the gear and this is the brake. I said, uh-huh, all right. He's like, all right, go. I'm like, and I'm going faster. I'm banging gears. I'm like, yeah, woo! Right? He's like, stop, you gotta slow down. I'm like, I can't. I hit the brake, and all of a sudden this brake cable's flapping in my face. I'm like, oh my God. I hit this mound of dirt, and I go flying, and I land in a basketball court. And all I know is I was a human scab. My whole back was like, ah, ah. I was like, we should return this bike. Ah. I did some damage. I was no bueno. I had scabs on me for... Then I'd sit near this weirdo on my school bus. He'd be like, scabs. He's like, hey, can I have some of your scab? I was like, yeah, sure. Weird kid. Weird. I said, this one's not quite ready yet. I'll get you tomorrow. Who knows where he is nowadays? He probably started a Scab Aficionado magazine. He's probably a millionaire. This is issue number 379. And this is the last of the last. Adventure Comics, issue number 384. All right, the cover's by Chris Swan and Murphy Anderson. And this is cool. This guy's name is, what is his name? Linda Danver falls for this guy. Lonin or something like that? I can't remember. Volar. This is Volar. She's like, he's a dreamboat. And Superman's like, I don't know. I don't think he... It turns out, Volar is a chick. He's been pretending to be a boy because the planet he comes from, the girls are lower class, so he pretends to be a boy. And then at the end, she's like, hey, you're a chick. He's like, yeah, sorry. Forgot to tell you. So that didn't work out for her. But there is the Heroin Haters. That's what that one is. And then there's Supergirl's Greatest Failure. That's by Kurt Schaffenberger. Yeah, man. Guys, it's great to have you back, man. Thanks for sitting through the Starman classes. You guys are the best. And enjoy your Sunday. Enjoy your Sunday. Thanks for joining me. Sonya, it's just me and you. Hawk Dog took a cab. He thinks I'm weird because I play with popsicle sticks. Come on. Egad, man. So, guys, let's take it up. Beckerman, where is he?
Beckerman.
Here's Beckerman. How you doing, Jim? Oh, I'm fine. You want to hear some music? Oh, I love your harmonica playing. You bet, man. Get a good seat. Here we go. All right. Okay. Let's take it out. I'm glad Ron is doing better. Ron's home, doing great. Reading comics. He's got a little back pain. My friends are popsicle sticks. Lead paint doesn't like my finger licks. Just me and Hawk Dog in the house. If I had a third nipple, I would wear a blouse. Ron Foss's spine fell apart. Now he is home reading comics, and they make him smart. Read your comics. They make you smart.